Yes. Oh, sexy. There then. Come on, sardine and mackerel. What was a tiger? Oh, you big cat, aren't you? Here's Nasha. Oh. Oh, who left that there? Oh. Oh, hello, Snowy. Is that good? Is that good? You good little cat.
Oh, you haven't seen my headscarf with the roses on, have you? Oh, I'll take that as a no, shall I?
Oh, sorry, no, I haven't, no.
Great party, eh?
Yeah.
You and Ben seem to be getting on okay.
Yeah, we did, didn't we? I really think I might...
Oh, no, 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 don't use the L word. Not this early in the morning, please.
Okay.
Today, we want everything to be nice for him, don't we?
Got much on today?
A bit more than I had on earlier.
Well, that's an image to get me through the day.
Scotty, Nasha, stop that. Stop it. No.
Hi, Andrea.
Hello, Harry.
That time of the month again.
Yes.
Ooh, that looks nasty.
Yes, it is. I think I better go to the doctors and get it looked at, actually.
Oh, right, yeah. What about,
Oh, the money's on the mantelpiece. I'll see you later, maybe.
All right, yeah. Okay.
No bike today?
Nope, puncture.
Good weekend.
Yeah, excellent, actually.
Oh, sorry, we're not really open yet.
Oh, I am a patient here.
Oh, well, you should really go to casualty if it's serious. Oh.
Look, let's have a look. OK, there's no need to bother St. Phil's with that, but it will need cleaning. I'll squeeze you in before my first patient.
Oh.
Are you okay? Well, you haven't exactly been the life and soul of the party the last few days.
No, I've just had a lot on my mind.
Anything you want to talk about?
Not really. Listen, I should be going. I'm a bit late.
Yeah, me too. Thanks for the lift.
No problem. Makes sense working around the corner.
Jude, I am always here for you. If you ever need to talk things through, that's what sisters are for.
Actually, there is something I need to tell you.
Well, when I say always...
Are you free for lunch?
It's our busiest time. Please.
It's important.
Okay. Seems it's you. See you later.
Bye.
You sure it was a cat that did this? That's more like a tiger.
Oh, well, that's Nasha. He can be a bit fierce.
Well, I'm just going to clean it up because it really doesn't need any stitches.
Oh, good.
Keep a lot of cats, then?
Quite a few, yeah. Thing is, I get too fond of them. The cats, I mean. Don't like to let them go.
It must be quite expensive, feeding them all.
Oh, yes, it is. And I'm running out of space.
In fact, there was never much between us in the first place.
And does she feel the same way too?
Yeah, I think so.
I'm not so sure. She made a big play for you at the party, and I saw the way she was looking at you just now.
Hey, we're just good friends.
I'm not sure she sees it that way. I think you need to talk to her, set the record straight.
Really?
Yes. If that's really the way you feel about Faith, you have to let her know.
Anyone for coffee?
There you are. Now, when did you last have a tetanus jab?
Last year.
Oh, yeah. Have you got any kittens?
Yeah. I've got a little sweetie called Barley.
Only, I've got a new flatmate and I thought a little kitten might make a really nice housewarming present.
Oh, well, you should come round sometime, have a look.
Oh, yeah, I will. You free this lunchtime?
Yes, I can be.
Great. How about 1:15?
Oh, thanks very much then.
Faith.
Right, I'll see you later.
All right. Just wait by the desk and I'll make an appointment for you. I won't be a minute.
It's okay. House call. Oh.
Ben has got the hots for you.
What?
How do you know?
I heard him telling Carly.
Why would he be telling Carly that he's got the hots for me?
Well, I don't know. They're close, those two, aren't they?
Do you mean close?
Oh, not like that, silly. They're mates.
So what did he say exactly?
Well, I can't remember his exact words, but they were talking about his feelings for you. His feelings. Well, you've got to go for it now.
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, Faith, back at the flat, you were saying he was the love of your life.
Hey, I thought we weren't allowed to use the L word.
Yes, well, not then, obviously, but now we're in full possession of the facts.
Oh, I don't know where I stand with Ben. One minute everything's fine between us, then he's flirting with Carly. Then after splitting up, he says he just wants to be friends. Now you're telling me he really does care about me?
Well, you've got to talk to him, find out what he really feels. I mean, he can't keep messing you about like this, blowing hot and cold. You don't think he's gay, do you?
No. I know the reason. Well, I know the reason he gave me. Sorry, it's personal. I've said too much already.
Well, there's your challenge, isn't it? Somebody has got to make a man out of Ben Kwame. And from what he's been saying, that somebody is you.
Oh, are you going anywhere exciting?
Meeting Beth.
Oh, well, say hello from me, won't you?
I will.
Would you fancy lunch?
No, I'm meeting someone. I don't suppose you fancy a bit of lunch?
No, I've got a date.
A date?
Well, not a date. I'm meeting someone.
Yeah, of course you are. Good luck. Honestly, Carly, some of the things that go on in this practice.
How do you mean?
Oh, well, I can't actually say. I mean, unless you're free for a little bit of lunch.
Sorry, busy. Another time, perhaps?
Yeah, great.
JC, I haven't got long.
Okay. So, how are you then?
Well, much the same as I was at breakfast, really.
Right, of course.
So what's this all about?
How do you mean?
Well, you've been behaving so strangely recently, I assumed you were going to tell me why.
Come on, Jude. Don't blank me. What happened? And? Sean's alive, Beth. And he came to the flat.
Okay. You've just told me the man I've spent the last 8 years thinking I've killed is alive and well. When did you see him?
Last week.
Last week? And you've only just got round to telling me now?
He asked me not to.
Oh, I see. So this guy who's haunted our lives for I don't know how long, this violent drug dealer, the guy who almost ripped us apart, suddenly rises from the dead and asks you nicely not to mention it, and you agreed.
I thought I could reason with him, and then he would leave us alone.
Well, I've got to see him. Where is he?
Well, he's gone.
Gone where?
I don't know, just gone.
What, and that's it? He suddenly appears after all this time. You two have a nice cosy chat and everything's sorted. Bye-bye, Sean. Sorry about leaving for dead in the middle of the desert, but now we can all be friends again.
It wasn't like that. He's changed.
I don't believe it.
I wanted to tell you. That's why I've been in such a state for the last few days.
I had a right to know, Jude.
I was trying to protect you.
I am quite old enough to look after myself and I don't need that kind of protection.
I did what I thought was best. But don't you see what this means, Beth?
What?
All that guilt that you've been carrying around.
You can let it all go now. It doesn't mean anything anymore. If Sean's alive, then you didn't kill him. You're not a murderer.
Hi.
Sorry about the mess.
Oh, you should see my place.
This is Barley.
She's so sweet. Hello.
Hello. Have you got time for a cup of tea?
No, thanks.
You don't mind if I do?
No, go ahead. Oh, Katrina's gonna love you.
Oh, is that your flatmate?
Yeah. She's a receptionist that works at the surgery.
Oh, I've always lived alone. Cats have always been enough company for me. Till now.
Andrea? Look, it's all right. If you take mine. Where's your mop?
In the bathroom. Oh. I'm sorry. Silly losing it like that. Never cry over spilt milk. She always used to say that.
Never keep a dog and bark yourself. That used to be my nan's favourite. Bless her. She's dead now. She used to live not far from here.
Yeah. Mine went a few years ago. She brought me up. My parents died when I was little.
Oh, I'm sorry. Any brothers or sisters?
No. It's just me. Till now.
Andrea, tell me to mind my own business. But I couldn't help but notice the pregnancy test kit in there.
I just done it before you came. It should be ready now. I can't.
It's all right. Here. Well, would you like me to go and get it and, well, we can look at it together? We need to talk.
What about?
Us, our relationship. What?
Relationship? Well, that's a bit serious, isn't it?
Sorry, I thought we were...
No, we are.
Because if you don't want to...
No!
No, you mean you don't?
No, I mean I do. Yes, I do.
What?
I want to have a relationship with you.
You do?
Yes.
Aren't I?
Yes! You most definitely are!
Sorry, it's all that skulking around at work. It just gets a bit confusing.
Well, once you settle in, we can tell everyone.
Right here.
What?
Yeah. When we tell everybody, let's bring them down here and then you and I stand up here and tell them all.
You're mad.
Oh, no. Have I got a deal then? Positive. Are you going to have a baby? Is there someone I can call?
No. No, there's no one.
What about the baby's father?
Oh, no. Would you go now, please? Please.
Come in.
All done?
Not quite. I just need to give you a quick checkup.
Thanks. I can't. came to apologise about earlier.
That's all right.
Look, can I buy you a drink to say sorry?
Well, we were just going to Leather Bites around the corner.
Well, that would be perfect.
Well, I'll catch up with you later. That's good.
Sorry I lost it earlier on. Only, well, it was a bit of a shock finding out I was pregnant like that.
It's okay. You don't have to talk about it if you don't want to.
Oh, no, but I want to. I need to talk it through with someone. You see, the thing is, I don't know what to do.
Oh, go on.
Well, I've never been one for relationships. I haven't got many friends, not close friends I could talk things through with. And as for blokes, well, I'm no Claudia Schiffer. I realised pretty early on that I wasn't the type that blokes make a beeline for. And to be honest, that suited me fine. I mean, I had my granny and my cats and life was okay. Then granny died and everything turned upside down again. After granny had gone, I had to move out of her house and into the bedsit. And then the next big thing happened. I met Harry. Look, Aftab, the old bloke who owned the house where I lived, he popped his clogs and Harry bought it, so he was my new landlord.
I see. And you and him started going out together?
Oh, no, nothing like that. Not going out. Or staying in, really. Well, Aftab, he didn't mind about the cats and everything else. But Harry, well, he had a strict no pets rule.
So what did you do?
Well, I didn't know what to do at first. I got nowhere else to go. And the cats were so happy there. So I begged Harry to let me stay.
So, you and him got together because of the cats?
Well, yes, we did really. But it was a bit more complicated than that.
I don't follow.
Well, Harry let me keep the cats on one condition. Once a month, when he came to get the rent money, I had to agree to have sex with him.
I guess you've been waiting for us.
Oh, well, it is 5 past. I don't get overtime.
Sorry to keep you. Ben, would you like a lift home, seeing as you haven't got your bike?
Yeah, that'd be great, Carly.
Our faith's in the leather bar.
Pardon?
Faith in the leather bar. Well, I just thought you might like to know. I'll just make sure everything's switched off.
That's terrible.
What?
Him taking advantage of you like that, forcing you to have sex with him.
Oh, no, no, he never forced me. And I thought it was quite a good idea, really. I mean, he was the first person who'd paid me any attention before.
You call that paying attention to you?
Well, it was the best offer I'd ever had. And it meant I could keep the cats.
Okay.
Well, no, to begin with, it was a bit weird. I mean, he'd come round every month and we'd do it and then he'd take his money and go. But, well, after a while, I realised I was looking forward to Harry coming round. And so was he. Well, over the months, we got quite fond of each other. Nearly 2 years we've been together now. I was beginning to think we might have some sort of future together.
And you got pregnant?
Yes.
Does Harry know?
No. No, and I'm scared. I'm really scared about what he's going to say.
Why?
Because he's a bloke, isn't he? I mean, this once-a-month arrangement suited him down to the ground. He was getting his nookie regularly, and he didn't have to do any of those things that you have to do in a relationship. I'm worried this baby's going to ruin everything.
You could always consider a termination if you're really that worried.
Oh, no, no. I think all life is sacred, whether it's a cat or a human. Something to be loved and cherished.
Well, maybe he'll surprise you. He might be pleased.
No, he won't be.
How do you know?
He's got a strict no kids rule as well.
Why is Katrina so keen on me seeing Faith?
Well, it's obvious. Faith fancies you, and even Katrina can see that. You've got to do something about this, Ben. Nip it in the bud before she gets hurt.
Yeah, I suppose so.
You don't have to tell her about us. Just make it clear that you and her are not an item.
Okay, I'll do it tomorrow. All right, I'll do it now.
Andrea, you're going to have to tell Harry about the baby.
I know, and I'm going to. I've arranged to meet him here, actually.
Do you want me to stay?
No. No, it'll be all right. It's our first proper date. I mean, apart from at my place, you know. That's why I dressed up a bit.
Oh, I see.
There he is.
Oh, look, I better leave you to it. If you need me, I'll be by the bar.
Thanks.
Hello.
Oh, Katrina said you'll be here.
Fancy a drink?
Oh, let me get him. Actually, I want to have a word with you.
Okay. I'm just going to pop to the ladies first.
A large whiskey, please. In fact, make it a triple.
Hi, Beth. It's me. Listen, I know you said you were going to be home late, but can you let me know what time? Talk later. Bye. Beth? Sean, is that you?
This is nice, isn't it?
Yes.
Out having a drink? No cats. Just the two of us.
You like that? Just the two of us?
Yeah, I do, yeah. I've been thinking...
Harry, there's something I've got to tell you.
Well, can't it wait? There's something I've got to talk to you about.
No, no, it can't.
Well, it'll have to. Andrea, I know we got off to a bit of a strange start, but I've got very, fond of you. In fact, and I've never really said this to anyone before, but actually, I think I love you. And I was wondering if maybe you'd like to come and live with me, in my house. Then we could be together all the time. You and me. The two of us.
The two of us?
Yeah. Just us. You and me.
But it wouldn't be just the two of us.
Oh, I know. Don't worry. The cats can come too. It's a big house. It's got three bedrooms. One for us and one for the cats.
One for the baby.
What?
I'm pregnant, Harry. I'm going to have a baby. Oh, you can forget about asking me to move in. I understand.
You're joking, ain't you? I've always wanted kids. Oh, come here. Oh.
What's that for?
Just happy, that's all.
Oh. Oh, right.
So, what did you want to talk to me about?
I was just...
Faith, I wanted you to meet Harry.
Oh, hello. This is Ben.
We're moving in together. And he's really pleased about pregnancy.
Oh, that's great news.
Yeah, congratulations.
I'm just popping down to the car. Don't go anywhere, will you?
I thought you said you were going to be back late. I got sent home. I was in the right state after what you told me about Sean.
I thought you were him, and then I thought he'd done...
And I thought you said he was going away and wasn't coming back.
I brought barley for you.
Oh, thanks.
Does your boyfriend like cats?
Oh, he's... I don't know, do you?
Actually, I'm not her...
Well, we ought to be going. Taken up too much of your time already.
Oh, we could stop for one more if you like.
No, let's leave these two alone. Besides, it's rent day, remember?
She thought we were an item.
Oh, yeah, look, I want
Hello.
To...
Hello. Sorry, I'm not interrupting, am I?
No. Look, I better be off anyway.
But didn't you want to,
Oh, we can wait. Now's not the best time anyway. Bye.
How's it going? I don't know. I think I was about to find out until you showed up.
Oh, sorry, I didn't realise.
Doesn't matter. I'm sure he'll tell me in his own way.
But tell you what.
I don't know, to be honest.
So what you got there, then?
It's a kitten.
Oh, no, no, I'm allergic. I'm allergic.
Oh.
Yeah, I mean, I just sneeze non-stop when I'm around cats. He's not for us, is he?
Oh, no. He's a present for me, Mum.
Oh.
Listen, Beth. I'm sorry. You were right. I should have told you sooner.
Look, it's okay. He's already put a wedge between us once. We mustn't let him do it again.
I'll drink to that.
You don't really think he's gone for good, do you?
I want it to be true. He has changed. Really.
Come on, Jude. A leopard doesn't change its spots. Shauna's come back here for a reason. He wants something.
Yeah, but what?
I don't know. How could either of us know what's going on in that sick mind of his? He could go to the police, anything. Why is he really here? What does he really want from us?